Hello, today I'm going to share with you the very easy, fast, and very new way to make bánh cuốn without standing too long at the hot place where the stove is, or if you have problem for your joy pan, you can just plug it in this 8-inch machine anywhere with the outlet. And even in the cool place, so you can make the bánh cuốn, or you can just sit on the floor and comfortable to do it without standing too long at the hot place. So this bánh cuốn here is made from 8-inch electronic pan, and it tastes very yummy compared with other methods. It's nothing different or better. And this bánh cuốn will be served at with the bean sprout, shallot, mint, and then pork sauces. So first of all, this is how we're going to mix the powder. Is you need one bag of Vĩnh Thuận powder, and you mix with 1,200 ml of water, and put this whole thing, after you mix it up, put the whole thing in the fridge overnight. And then the next day, you bring it out, scoop out the top, water on the top, scoop it out, and replace with the same amount with the hot water. After that, put a little bit oil and a pinch of salt. Okay, here comes the fun part. You're going to need a non-stick tray, and you're going to prepare a wet folding paper to hold the machine, you know, so it's not prevent the hot when you're holding the machine up to put the powder in, just like that, okay? And then you use the non-stick trays to put the crepe when you take it out. So the machine now is plugged in. As you can see, it's very small, 8-inch. Normally, I'm going to use two machines, but first of all, I'm going to share with you how to use one. And when you get used to it, you can use both of them for faster. Okay? So make sure you stir up the powder. Make sure you stir up that. And then do one scoop, just like the amount I'm using right now here. Okay, remember, lift up the machine, tilt over, okay, and pour right at the middle. And then you roll the machine to make sure the mix is all evenly, and then you close the lid. Okay, at this time here, you just wait for a few minutes, okay, and then you can open the lid and then wait a little bit to make sure the crepe is all is around the crepe is like it's really have to cook to make it not stick together, not stick at the pan. Make sure you leave it on the pan a little bit longer, okay? After you open the lid, you leave a little bit longer to make sure around the crepe there is kind of lift it up a little bit. Then you take it out. It would be nicer. Okay. And if you pay attention to the tool I use, is a big surface of the spatula. Try to find that one. It's very easy for you to take out the crepe. See? So see when it's, the crepe is cooked. Easy to take it out, you just lift it up and take it out upside down, you put on the tray, okay? The crepe now is very nice, thin, okay? And before you put the filling on the crepe, you're gonna add the another scoop of the mix to the machine, you know, while waiting, so we can, you know, you take turn to do here and there for faster. Okay, remember, lift it up and, you know, roll around the machine to make sure the mix all around, and then you can add some mix, some you know, powder if it missed some spot here and there. Okay, so about the filling, I'm gonna put at the end, okay, just a little bit at the end, folding both sides. And at this time, you can lift up the lid for the machine. Okay, so now you roll up the roll just like this. See, we have one nicely done. Very quick. Very quick. So now, it's time you take the second one out. But please make sure the crepe, around the crepe, is all lift up a little bit. Okay, so you can take it out easily. Okay, just like this, see? Now, take it out, upside down, put on the tray. Just like that. Don't worry about the mix-up because you can pull it out, see? You can pull it out like that. Okay, now get another scoop, the mix, and pour to the pan before you add the filling. So, you just take turn to do this and you go back to the filling and so you don't have to wait long, okay? Lift up and pour right in the middle of the machine. Roll around the machine to make sure the mix all evenly, okay? Now you close the lid and you put the filling. The filling, you can add whatever you want. You can add more or less, it's up to you. And then roll it up just like that so it shows nicely at the end, the filling. You can see that. Okay, see the second one done very nicely, so you finish very fast. Okay, so it's time to open the lid for the other one. Okay, see, I think it's time now. I'm gonna try to use two machines, okay? Because with two machines take turn, you won't have to wait that long with the one machine. But first of all, try at home with one machine first. You use it, then you can do twice, two of them. So it's a lot faster to do with both. Okay, so same thing. You lift it up the machine, pour the mix right in the middle, roll around the machine to make sure the mix is all evenly, close the lid, and now it's time to take out the first one. See? Now around the crepe is ready, easily to take it out. Upside down, put on the tray, okay? Before you add the filling, you're gonna put the scoop of the mix to the pan. Just like this. Lift up and pour hot right in the middle. See, and roll around the machine, to make sure all evenly the mix. Before you add the filling for the crepe, you open the other lid. See? And then now you're gonna add the filling, roll it both sides, roll it at the end, and finish nicely. Just like that. Okay. So before you take out the other one, you can open the lid. So for this crepe is done nicely, and then you can take the other one out. See, just like that, upside down, put it over on the tray. See, nicely, very thin. You can pull it out, so don't worry. No worry about the mix up, the mess like that. Okay, now before you add the filling to the crepe, you're gonna pour the mix to the other pan. And again, same thing, lift it up the machine and pour right in the middle, lift it up, roll around the machine to make sure the mix all evenly. Okay, so now we're gonna put the filling again at the end, fold two sides, roll from the end to the front, and that's it, nicely done. Now, before you take out the crepe, you're gonna open the lid from the other one. See, you just take turn, do this and this, machine both of them, so you don't have to wait long in between. Okay, so now, again, this is very nice crepe, nice and thin. You can pull straight out without worry. Okay, so yeah, lift it up the machine, tilt it over, pour right in the center, right in the center, and lift it over. See, like this. Sometimes it missing some spot, no worry. You can add a little bit like that. See, and close the lid, and now we add the filling. Well, in this video, I did not share how to do the filling. I'm gonna do for the next one. So if you like, you check it out, okay? Follow it up and you can see, or you can do any kind of filling you want. You can put chicken, you can put beef, anything. Even you can make the veggie very nicely and very tasty. Okay, so see, very easy to put out, so no worries at all. Okay, now before you put the filling again, you scoop another mix to the other machine. Tilt it over, put right in the center, and then roll around the machine, make sure it's all evenly. Close the lid, and we will add the filling. Okay, same thing. See, when you do two machines, it's very, you don't have to wait long, so you don't see it, it is, you know, you don't see it long in between. Now, remember, before you take this one out, you're gonna lift, open the lid. Now, see, this is a case, okay? You're gonna see this when you do it. So no worry, just take it out upside down normal, because we're gonna have the way to hide that messy thing, see? Okay, before we finish that one, we're gonna pour the mix to the other, the pan first, okay? Remember, lift it up the machine, put right in the middle. Run around, roll around, and make sure it's even. Okay, add a little bit here, that's it. Okay, now we go back to the crepe. See, like this, we have the messy one, so we're gonna add the filling at the nicely place, you know? Fold it at the side, same thing, and roll it up. See, you hide it. You won't see any messy at all, see, nicely done. So when you see the case like that, you do not worry, because we can fix it up and we don't see the mess at the end. Okay, check it out. You see, we're gonna finish one plate very soon, like, you know, very fast with the two machine. But I know it's gonna be hard to do with two at the first time. You have to get used to it with one first, then you can use the second one. Okay, you see some spot like that, we can add a little bit more, that's all. Try not to put too heavy of the mix, because otherwise it's gonna be too thick. So you practice, and you know for the next time, you know, when you do the first time, you know how to do for the next one. So just practice and you get better. Open the lid for the other one before you take out the crepe from the first one. Just take turn just like that. There we go, upside down again. Okay, straighten up, so no worries. Okay, before you add the filling, you're gonna add the mix to the other pan first. There we go. Same thing, roll over to make sure. Okay, close the lid. Then we're gonna put the filling. Okay, roll it up both sides. Roll it up and finish at the end. Nicely done, another one. Okay, before you take out the other one, you open the lid for the first one. Now it's time to take out the other one, see? Upside down. Before you add the filling of this one, you're gonna pour the mix to the other one. See, you take turn just like that, and then you don't have to wait long. You don't feel it long to wait. So that's why I love to do two machines at the same time. And then if I don't have to say, I don't have to explain anything, I do very fast. in one bag, like one bag, one mix it today like that, I do in half an hour for the to finish it out with two machines. But you know, you don't have to worry, don't panic, just take your time. You learn a little bit at the first, and then you practice, and you can get used to it, and you can do it better for next time. So, see how nicely done? The crepe is quite nice, thin, and it's very good, you know? With the original way of the bánh cuốn is thin by the, you know, from the pot with the material, with the fabric. That is the original way, but you know, somehow it takes too much time, and then you know, I find this way, I create this way, so we can do it you know, as good, you know, and then it's fast and it's comfortable to do it. Sometimes you can just sit on the floor, prepare the place, and then you do comfortably, because somebody cannot stand, you know, long to do it. So with this way, I hope you can find the easy way for you to make bánh cuốn without, you know, standing too long. This I stand in my kitchen counter, so it's very nice and cool. I don't have to stand the hot and then, you know, kind of boring. See, look at that. I finished a plate, look delicious, yummy, and it's very fast. You can do it, because you know, when you practice 1-2 times, you can do it. Look how nice and yummy it is. Hey, look delicious. And it is delicious, not just the look. I promise. See, this is the plate of bánh cuốn I make from the 8-inch machine. Look very nice, very good, and taste yummy. Okay, and I hope you will like it the way I'm sharing. Try to practice it to do for your family, for your friend. And also, you know, the rice roll can be made with different filling, like with shrimp or, you know, with the beef. You can put it wrapped with lettuce and beef to put it inside. And then you also do at the veggie. So it's just choice. It's very a lot of choice to do with the rice roll. Okay, see how yummy it is. This is all done by the machine, 8-inch, very fast, very easy. I hope you like it, and give me the thumbs up. Share, please share, and you know, subscribe the channel and support Lee Dynasty Kitchen. I hope you enjoy it, and don't forget to check for my next video, how to make the fried Vietnamese sausage to eat with the rice roll. This is a very yummy dish, and then very tasty, and have to have with the rice roll, with the bánh cuốn. So you cannot miss that. Okay, again, bánh cuốn will be served with you know, bean sprout, lettuce if you like, and shallot, and sauces, of course. So I hope you enjoy, and thank you very much for support Lee Dynasty Kitchen, and I hope to see you next time.